Happy Sunday, children. I hope all of you are safe and well. Teacher Darmawan here, and we are going to start our Sunday school today. Let's start our Sunday school with a word of prayer taken from the Lord's Prayer. One of Jesus' disciples saw Jesus pray to God, and then he asked him, "Lord, teach us to pray." And Jesus taught them the Lord's Prayer. So let's pray together and repeat after me. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen. Now, let us praise the Lord. Today, we are going to sing, "I Will Sing of the Mercies of the Lord Forever." All right. Before we listen to the Bible story, let's play a quick game. Who did it? As you can see on the screen, we have pictures of people that were written in the Bible, such as the rich young ruler, the Israelites, the Pharisees, Hophni and Phinehas, Eli, Cain, Potiphar's wife, Zacchaeus, Ahab and Jezebel, and King Saul. Now, I'm going to give you a clue about one of these people. When I'm finished giving the clue, I will ask who did it. And can you tell me the answer? We will play this game this way until all the people have been identified. Are you ready? Let's begin. He murdered his brother. Do you know who he is? He is Cain. Next. Before he met Jesus, he stole from others. Who could this be? He is Zacchaeus. Next, they worshipped a golden calf. Oh, these must be the Israelites. They took God's part of the offering for themselves. Children, do you know who they are? Yes, they are Hophni and Phinehas. Next, she wanted Joseph for herself. So who did it? She was Potiphar's wife. This person loved his riches more than he loved God. Who is this person? He is the rich young ruler. These people made up their own Sabbath rules. Who are they? They are the Pharisees. And this person did not discipline his sons. He is Eli. And lastly, second last, these people lied against Naboth. Naboth is the owner of a vineyard. Do you know who they are? They are King Ahab and Queen Jezebel. And lastly, we have this person who was jealous of David. Who is he? He is King Saul. Right, I hope you get all the persons correct. Okay, so all these people broke God's law. They could not keep the Ten Commandments. They all sinned against God. How about us? Do we break the Ten Commandments? Yes. Do we sin against God? Yes. And that is why we need a Savior. Now it's time for the Bible story. Children, we have learned that God gave his people 10 good rules to help them know how to love God and how to love one another. Do you remember what they are? Let's read and memorize them. Commandment 1, thou shalt not have other gods before me. Commandment 2, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image. Commandment 3, thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain. Commandment 4, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. Commandment 5, honor thy father and thy mother. Commandment 6, thou shalt not kill. Commandment 7, thou shalt not commit adultery. Commandment 8, thou shalt not steal. Commandment 9, thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. And commandment 10, thou shalt not covet thy neighbor's house. Now, do any of us obey these commandments perfectly? Sadly, no. And children, when you think about it, in what way do we often disobey God's commandments? Can you think of a few examples? Yes, When we disobey our parent, or when we are mean to our friends or siblings, we are disobeying God's commandments. If we tried very hard, could we obey the Ten Commandments perfectly? Well, the answer is still no. We all fail, even when we try our best not to fail. Adam, the first person God made, sinned by disobeying God. And everyone born since then is born a sinner. We have a problem, don't we? Because God says that we must obey Him perfectly. But we can't obey Him perfectly because we are sinful. So, what do we need? Yes, we need a Savior to obey the commandments for us. And Jesus is that Savior. Jesus did not have a sinful heart, so He could obey God perfectly. Because He never sinned, He could die on the cross for our sins. God knew that we could never get to heaven by obeying His commandments perfectly. So He sent His own Son to keep the law for us. You know, that day, many, many years after the Israelites stood at Mount Sinai and heard God give His commandments, some people stood on a hill called Calvary and watched as cruel men nailed Jesus to the cross. Jesus had done nothing wrong. He did not deserve to die. But the Son of God suffered and died to save us from our sin. John chapter 3, verse 16 wrote, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only Son, that whoever believes in Him should not perish, but have eternal life." It makes us sad to think of Jesus suffering and dying, but it makes us glad to know that He did it because He loved us. He did it in order to give us the wonderful gift of forgiveness of sins. In conclusion, when we look at the commandments, we say, "I can't obey the commandments. I need a Savior." And when we look at the cross, we say, "Thank you, Jesus, for obeying the commandments for me. Thank you for dying so that my sins can be forgiven." When we look at the commandments and the cross, we say, "Because Jesus died for me, I want to show Him that I love Him. I want to show Him that I'm thankful." And we do that by obeying Him. The Ten Commandments teach us what is pleasing to God. We must ask the Holy Spirit to give us the help we need to love God and love one another. Do you remember what Jesus said when someone asked Him which commandment was the most important? Jesus said that the most important command is to love God. And He said that the second most important command is to love others. Let's read this verse together. "And He said to him, 'You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your mind. This is the great and first commandment. And a second is like it, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Matthew chapter 22, verse 37 to 39. And in Paul's second letter to the Corinthians, 2 Corinthians 5, chapter 5, verse 21, he wrote, "For our sake, he made him to be sin, who knew no sin, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God." This verse tells us that Jesus took our sin and punishment when he died on the cross. And now God accepts us because of Jesus' sacrifice for us when we repent and believe. Righteousness means that when God forgives our sin, he begins to treat us like Jesus, as if we had never sinned. Let's come to God in a word of prayer. Dear God, thank you for sending your Son, Jesus, to save us. Thank you for your love and forgiveness. Help us to please you by loving you and loving others. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, children, now it's time for our catechism. This week, we will go through catechism questions 76 to 79. Question 76. What is the sum of the Ten Commandments? To love God with all my heart and my neighbor as myself. Question 76. What is the sum of the Ten Commandments? To love God with all my heart and to love my neighbor as myself. Question 77. Who is your neighbor? All my fellow men are my neighbors. Question 77. Who is your neighbor? All my fellow men are my neighbors. Question 78. Is God pleased with those who love and obey him? Yes. He says, I love them that love me. Question 78. Is God pleased with those who love and obey him? Yes, he says, I love them that love me. Question 79. Is God displeased with those who do not love and obey him? Yes, God is angry with the wicked every day. Question 79. Is God displeased with those who do not love and obey him? Yes, God is angry with the wicked every day. All right, now it's time for activity. Children, you can ask your mommy and daddy to help you print this activity. And as you can see, this is a puzzle. And also, there's a quiz. So what you need to do is actually start from this point and follow to go to each boxes. In each boxes, there is a question and you can find the answer in the Bible first. Once you find the answer, you can proceed to the next box and again find the answer all the way till the finish line. And also you can do whatever that they instruct you to do over here. Okay, let's sing the doxology to bring all glories back to God. Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise him all creatures here below. Praise him above ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Amen. This is the end of our Sunday school today. See you next week, and God bless you.